House Speaker Nancy Pelosi to find a way out of impeachment yesterday?
Not at all, no. Look, she's lost her way. She's been taken over by the radical left. She may be radical left herself, but she really has lost her way. I spoke to her about guns yesterday. She didn't even know what I was talking about. She's not interested in guns. I'll tell you what, Nancy Pelosi is not interested in guns and gun protection and gun safety. All she's thinking about is this. She's been taken over by the radical left, the whole Democrat Party. And you take a look at what's happening in the media today. The whole party is taken over by the left. And thank you very much. My poll numbers have gone up. But I don't want it to go up for this reason. When they look and when you see what's happening, people are really angry at Democrats. They're really angry at the Democrat Party. And things like, as an example, drug pricing, getting drugs down, things like gun safety, infrastructure. The Democrats can't talk about that because they've been taken over by a radical group of people. And Nancy Pelosi, as far as I'm concerned, unfortunately, she's no longer the Speaker of the House. Thank you very much, everybody.
Mr. President, Attorney General, Attorney General, Attorney General, Attorney General, Attorney General, Attorney
General, thank you very much.
Okay. Last I've checked, Nancy Pelosi is the Speaker of the House. I have no idea what he was just referencing there. Number two, we just need to know before we analyze all of this that, you know, everything he said about the Bidens is 100% wrong. The accusations against the Bidens are baseless. There is no evidence of wrongdoing, including by Ukrainian prosecutors. Joe Biden is indeed on tape talking about withholding aid because the U.S. and Western nations wanted a corrupt prosecutor out. In fact, the goal of Western nations at the time was to get prosecutors who would investigate corruption. So first and foremost, those are the facts. Christiane Amanpour is with me, and we were listening to all of this together. And let's just begin with, you know, the money question was to the president of Ukraine as to whether or not he felt pressured. We've read the transcript. He essentially said, you've seen it all. You've read it. And he basically said, no one pushed me. And then Trump jumped in and said, there was no pressure. What did you think of that?
Well, the president of Ukraine is under enormous pressure right now. This is not the kind of spotlight he wants. He is a neophyte. He is not a political leader. He is a television personality. He was a comedian. He won in one of these extraordinary outsider, come from behind races in Ukraine. And he has now landed in one of the most dramatic political crises that his country could imagine, but also that the United States right now could imagine. So he is desperately punting for every way he possibly can. Earlier today, he said to Ukrainian correspondents who were following around that the only person who can pressure me is my six-year-old son. This is an independent country, and we will not be pressured into anything. The transcript, to an extent, speaks for itself, right? He talks about, President Trump talks about how he's been very helpful with military and how they've, you know, bought these javelin defense systems. And then President Trump says, fine, but I want you to do me a favor. I mean, this comes right after. To the point in question that they were talking about, and this is the prosecutor in the Ukraine. President Trump, according to this transcript, says that he needs him to look into the issue of the prosecutor in Ukraine. And Zelensky says, I want to tell you about the prosecutor. First of all, I understand and I'm knowledgeable about the situation since we've won the majority now in this country. The next prosecutor will be 100% my person, my candidate, who will be approved by the parliament and will start as a new prosecutor in September. He or she will look into the situation specifically to the company that you mentioned on this issue. So they're definitely talking about the same thing. And this President Zelensky is talking about the request for a favor that President Trump made. Mm-hmm. And I think that, you know, the other thing that's really very interesting in this is that President Trump, four times in this phone call, mentions not just Rudy Giuliani, but the Attorney General of the United States, and says that he wants Zelensky to work with the Attorney General on this issue of the prosecutor. And you know, and I know from my previous reporting, my previous interviews with the previous president of Ukraine, that corruption was a main focus of the United States. U.S. ambassadors were desperately trying to eradicate and reform the corrupt business practices and judicial practices and legal practices that are rife in the Ukraine. And so that was certainly something the Trump the Obama administration was trying to fulfill. And one other thing that's really important, this idea that the Europeans haven't been helping. Mm. The Europeans have given in the region of $16 billion to Ukraine to help it in all sorts of ways, democracy building, in terms of all the issues that it needs, because Ukraine wanted to be part of the EU. That's what started this entire issue. Mm. That's what made Russia invade Ukraine partly. And of course, you know, Ukraine needs a weapons systems and all the rest of it because it's at war with Russia right now.
The question where Trump kept bringing up Putin and you should get along with Putin, mm-hmm. and what, you know, we peace with Russia, and we were just
well,
all
that
noting.
Great,
but looking at Zelensky's face, he mm-hmm. was like,
yeah, I mean, look, there's a lot of tap dancing and punting going on here. Zelensky, if you look at the original beginning of this transcript,
I've seen Trump.
Yes, yeah, but you know, Trump is calling partly to congratulate, but as one prosecutor here told us today, this is a one issue conversation and it's about a domestic problem that President Trump raised, and that is to look into his main challenger for the 2020 race, and that's Joe Biden and his son.
Yeah.
Zelensky, though, starts the conversation on this July 24th call by essentially mimicking President Trump, by flattering President Trump, by saying, we used your tactics.
We tried to drain the swamp. I've stayed
at
your hotel. You're a great educator for
us. And even there, he was trying to make Trump feel comfortable, trying to deflect the limelight. And he is also, he's a pro in the spotlight. That's what he's done. He's a television personality.
Zelensky.
Yes, Zelensky.
And Trump.
And President Trump. So you've got a lot of currents conflicting here at the moment.